I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York, these vagabond shoes.
Streaming from your computer and from all over the internet, this is all Andy Alfred. Clayfan 2-3. And now your host, Andy Alfred.
I wanna wake up in a city that doesn't sleep. And find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap.
Oh, the Tigers take one from the Rays. The Mud Hens proved to win in the state capital of Ohio. And of course, I'm playing for it because the New York Yankees have swept the Cleveland Indians.
I'm melting away. I'll make a
brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York, New York. Hey, oh, I love you guys, and welcome into this another edition of All in the Upper right here on Clayfan 2. Three, I am your host, Andy Alfred, welcoming you into the Man Cave and welcoming you into this Wednesday, June 5th edition of All Andy Alfred. By the way, before we begin All Andy Alfred today, I would like to apologize. We didn't have a show on the program yesterday, of course. We had some plumbing issues here in the Man Cave, and it was pretty intense. We didn't have any water at one point, but we got everything squared away, got everything settled. We were okay. We're back to our normal self. But let's get into last night and then preview what happened this afternoon for the Indians. First of all, for the Detroit Tigers. Wow. 10 runs, and the Prince showed all Andy Alfred up yesterday. He still needs to get benched. But he's proven me that he's starting to step up to the plate. Tigers were a winner yesterday, 10-1 over the Tampa Bay Rays. Anibal Sanchez was just filthy, dirty, excellent last night. 6-5 with a 2.65 ERA. Morgan's lost his shortest outing of the season. He's 8-1 with a 2.95 ERA. No home runs for Tampa Bay. Omar Infante is fourth, and like I said, Prince Fielder had that bomb out to right center field. Beautiful home run. In front of 30,569, game time 3 hours and 3 minutes. Well, tonight, it will be game two of the series. It will be Doug Fister on the hill for the Detroit Tigers. He is 5-2 with a 3.28 ERA. He'll take on Cobb for Tampa Bay, who is 6-2 with a 2.66 ERA, game time 7-5 on FSN Detroit. And then tomorrow on the concluding game of the series, we'll be on the air after that game ends. It will be former Cleveland Indian Fausto Carmona. No, it's Hernandez. I forget his first name, of course. On the hill, he's 3-5 with a 4.87 ERA. He'll take on Max Scherzer, who is looking to go 8-0. He's 7-0 right now with a 3.42 ERA. Game time 105 FSN Detroit, or if you have it, MLB Network. But like I said, Prince is proving me wrong. I've had some people come out and say that you don't know what about Prince Fielder, you don't know his dominance. Last night he kind of proved me wrong a little bit, but I still believe he needs to be benched just so he can wake up and smell the honey and smell the Eggo waffles. We're gonna have Nick DeVero on the program tomorrow from Rational Pastime. He's gonna have a new article coming out tonight, later on this evening, about franchises. We'll talk about him. We'll talk a little bit about the MLB draft and also his impressions of the White Sox and the Central Division so far this season. Well, speaking of the Central Division, the Cleveland Indians went into the Bronx to take on the New York Yankees and have been swept by the New York Yankees. Well, let's get into Monday. Justin Masterson didn't cut it in New York. Masterson gets the loss. He goes to 8-4 with a 3.57 ERA. The Indians were a loser. 7 of all Yankees. Kelly gets the win. He goes to 3-0 with a 5.24 ERA. Mariano Rivera gets his 20th save of the season. Text message to the outfield. Home run for Mark Teixeira. Travis Happer with a former Cleveland Indian homer. His 9th of the season in front of 40,007. Game time, 2 hours and 58 minutes. Now, yesterday, it was the Indians again a loser, 4-3 to the New York Yankees. Scott Kazmir roughed up again. He goes down to 3-3 with a 5.24 ERA. Phelps gets the win for the New York Yankees. He's now 4-4 with a 4.15 ERA. Text message again out to the outfield. His 2nd of the season in front of 36,208. Game time, 3 hours and 14 minutes. Drew Stubbs homered for Cleveland. Mariano Rivera gets his 21st save of the season. And then today, just wrapped up a little bit ago, the Cleveland Indians were swept, and they lost today to their former ace, CC Sabathia. It was CC on the hill for the Yankees as the Yankees win 6-4. CC gets the win. He goes to 6-4 with a 3.74 ERA. He pitched a full 9-inning game, 7 hits, 4 runs, 4 of them, all 4 earned, 1 walk, 8 strikeouts, and 1 home run. Corey Kluber got rocked by Gardner in a 3-run home run in the game as Corey Kluber gets the loss. He goes to 3-4 with a 4.56 ERA. Yan Gomes homered his 6th of the season, and Travis Hafford his 10th for the Yankees in front of 42,477. Game time, 2 hours and 42 minutes. Now, the Indians will have tomorrow off, and they will head up to the Motor City to take on my Motor City Kitties of the Detroit Tigers. And we'll preview that big series starting tomorrow. It is a big series because of this. We'll get into that. Hold on. We'll get one in 1 second. Miami, we'll get into some scores from last night. Philadelphia was a winner 7-3 over the Miami Marlins. The Washington Nationals, it was a night of walk-offs, basically. Washington was a winner over the Mets 3-2. Colorado was a winner 5-4 over the Cincinnati Reds. Atlanta 5, Pittsburgh 4, Boston 17, Texas 5. Baltimore was a winner 4-1 over the Houston Astros. Minnesota was a winner 3-0 over the Kansas City Royals. Milwaukee pulls up the upset and beats the Hot A's 4-3 in extra innings. Arizona 7, St. Louis 6. The Angels were a winner 4-3 over the Chicago Cubs. The White Sox were a loser 4-7 to the Seattle Mariners. The Dodgers were a winner 9-7 over the San Diego Padres. And San Francisco beats Toronto 2-1. Day games going on. We have one final to report. Atlanta, Tan almost had a no-hitter. He went 7, giving up no runs. But he gave up a hit to the former Tiger, Brandon Inge, as the Braves were a winner 5-0 today. Just wrapping up, the Phillies were a winner 6-1 over the Miami Marlins. Oakland and Milwaukee are tied at 1-1. We're just getting underway in Seattle, 0-0. And Toronto and San Francisco are just getting underway, 0-0. And I want to get into the Pez stuff, but this big series with the Tigers and the Indians means a lot. Here's why. The Tigers, going into tonight's game, are 31-25, 4-6 in the last 10. With the Cleveland loss this afternoon, Cleveland is now 30-29, 2.5 out, 2-8 in their last 10. Minnesota is in third place. They have a record of 26-29, 4.5 out, 8-2 in their last 10. Now you say, Andy, well, who does Minnesota play after this? Because they could make a run against Cleveland. Glad you asked. They play the Washington Nationals this weekend in Nationals Park. Big test for them. Fourth place is the Chicago White Sox, who are just dropping like flies right now. They're 24-32, 7 games out, 2-8 in their last 10. And Kansas City's rounding out the division. They're 24-32, 7.5 out, 2-8 in their last 10. Chicago headed for the basement, and the Twinkies are surging. Well, the Ped list is coming out, and it might for the American Council or whatever it was. It's coming out. And A-Rod and Ryan Braun and the now Detroit Tiger, Johnny Peralta, or might be on the list. Might be getting a 50-game suspension. Melky Cabrera on the same list, too. My opinion about this. It's a shame. We don't have any more pure baseball players anymore in the world of sports, in the world of baseball. The last pure baseball player retired. That was Ken Griffey Jr. he will go down in the Hall of Fame, honestly. He will be a first ballot Hall of Famer. For what he has done for the game, for his career, first ballot. Given. Wearing the Mariner green, of course, today. But it is pathetic to take the drugs and to then, I mean, with all the major medicine in the world, you're going to a clinic in a strip mall to get shot up. It's about as bad as going to Subway and getting a sandwich from a trainee. Just saying. The Mudhens win in Columbus. They didn't take on the Blue Jackets. They took on the Clippers. But let's preview what happened Monday, because I was there, of course. I got the score sheet right here. Took some score code and took some notes as well at the same time. As well as I made up a sign, too. Fire Phil Nevin. Put that on the big board up there on the board. Pretty awesome. But Holiday striking out in the bottom of the fifth inning against the Louisville Bats. He had that swing that, you know, it's just a pure dance move.
Beautiful for him.
If this was Dancing with the Stars. Unbelievable. Galarraga pitched beautiful. I don't know why he's not a starter with the Cincinnati Reds. I know why. Because Latos, Cueto, and Arroyo. Get rid of Homer Bailey. Put Galarraga on there. He was dealing yesterday on Monday evening. As he picks up the win, he goes now to 4-3 with a 2.70 ERA as the Louisville Bats beat the Toledo Mudhens 3-2. Alvarez, the ace of the Mudhens staff, gets the loss. He goes to 5-4 with a 2.42 ERA. Billy Hamilton had an inside-the-park home run. It took him 14.6 seconds to round the bases at fifth third field. Unbelievable. Kevin Russo had his first home run of the season, and I was just bitching about him on Monday! Ah! In front of 5,522, game time, 2 hours and 24 minutes. Parchin gets the save. Now, yesterday, the Mudhens were starting up a home-and-home series, two-game series, two games home and home in Columbus. Mudhens were a loser yesterday, 11-8. Barnes gets the win. He goes to 3-2 with a 6.50 ERA. Sean Hill gets the start. He's now to 0-7 with a 6.38 ERA. When is this guy going to Erie? I'm asking that question, Phil. When is he going to Erie? 0-7, and he's one of your starters. Villarreal should be a starter. Dorn, his 12th. Nick Castellanos, his 8th. Lonnie Chisenhall, his 6th. And Fedoff, his 3rd. Gilbert gets the save for Columbus, his 15th of the season in front of 8,670. Game time, 3 hours and 15 minutes. Now, this afternoon, the Mudhens played a noon game against the Columbus Clippers and gets the victory 9-4. Hankins on the hill dealing. He was dealing. He gets the win. He goes to 2-3 with a 3.46 ERA. Martinez gets the loss for Columbus. He now goes to 1-5 with a 6.95 ERA. Villarreal gets his first save of the season as the Mudhens win 9-4 over the Columbus Clippers. Nick Castellanos is 9th. And Kevin Russo is 2nd of the season. He's got 2 home runs already. He might be coming off of the top 5, bottom 5 next week. You never know. From 10,328 game time, 2 hours and 46 minutes. Now going into the rest of the play of tonight in the IL. Indianapolis leads the division. They're 40-20 in their first place. 6-4 in the last 10. Columbus is now in second place. They are 30-30. They're at 500. They're 10 games under 500. 2-8 in their last 10. I say this because Louisville plays tonight. They are 29-30. 10.5 out. 5-5 in their last 10. Win tonight. They tie for second place. But don't worry about having a third three-way for second place. Because the Toledo Mudhens are 21-40. 19.5 out, 6-4 in their last 10 games. Well, you pulled one out of your head today, Phil. But we still want to fire Phil Nevin. Hashtag fire Phil Nevin. Follow the show at all Andy Alfred. And hey, I got a tweet I got to read here in just a little bit. I'm pulling out my phone right now, as you can see, as I'm pulling it out right now. Let's get into a little bit more. The NHL playoffs tonight. Game 3 in the Boston Garden, TD Garden. Boston leads the series 2-0 over the Pittsburgh Penguins. Game time tonight at 8 o'clock on NBC Sports Network or CBC. Boston cruise to a big victory 6-1 over the Pittsburgh Penguins. Last night, the LA Kings were winner 3-1 over the Chicago Blackhawks, and takes the series at 2-1. NHL 14 will be releasing their cover at the start of the Stanley Cup Finals. Will Sergei Bobrovsky win it? Let's keep our fingers crossed, boys. Keep our fingers crossed. Well, it's set. David Stern, you got your wish. It will be the Miami Heat to take on the San Antonio Spurs tomorrow night at 9 o'clock on NBC, on ABC. 9 o'clock tip, 8:30 pregame, as the Miami Heat beat the Indiana Pacers on Monday, 99-76. I'm making my prediction right now, folks. This is going to be the best series to watch. The old three versus the big three. Ginobili, Parker, Duncan versus Bosch, Wade, and LeBron James. I don't know who to pick. I was tossed up. I don't want LeBron to win it. I think it's going to go the full seven. And I think the San Antonio Spurs will win the championship this year in the NBA. Got some tweets to read out, too. I want to give a shout-out here. One tweet is from, let's see here. I'm pulling it up now. Jack the Bear Jew. And he writes it, watching all Andy at all Andy Alfred, always stays tuned to ClayFan23. Give a big out shout out to Jackson Maxwell. You are the man, of course. Because I love you guys, and happy birthday, America! That's for him out there. Because I know he loves hearing me say that. And I also want to give a shout out to White Sox 901 for me calling out Prince Fielder on the air. I've been getting a lot of heat for that, but nevertheless, it's just very interesting. Some recommendations for today. Don't forget to get your tickets for the Mud Hens game for tomorrow night and also for Friday. Matt LaPorta returns in his fifth third field debut this season against the Toledo Mud Hens. I won't be in attendance, unfortunately, because I have to work all weekend. So I do apologize for that, but get away with that for Matt. But call up, get some tickets. We have plenty of tickets, 419-725-HENS or mudhens.com, or go down to 406 Washington to get your tickets. Don't forget to go pick up the copy of Michael Bublé's To Be Loved album. Get it at Target. They have a bonus track with 3 extra songs. Go out, pick up a couple dozen copies. You Make Me Feel So Young, To Be Loved, and the popular hit, It's a Beautiful Day. Michael Bublé, To Be Loved. Go pick it up right now at your local store. Also, got to give a shout-out to Dr. Zuhari in Fisher's office with one location in Rossford, Ohio. Hey, you know, I go there. They fix my smile every time. I tell you that because they're the truth. They do a great job. It's a family-run business and so much more. So set up an appointment by calling 419-666-3327. That's 419-666-3327, or visit zfdentist.com. That's zfdentist.com. They have fixed the smile. They can fix yours at the same time. On tomorrow's show, we will break down the Tiger game from last night and also from tomorrow afternoon, as well as previewing the Mudhen game for tomorrow night against the Columbus Clippers, and previewing also and breaking down what happened tonight in the NHL playoffs. Well, I want to wish you all a very a good day to you all. I hope you have a terrific rest of the day, and as always, I'm pulling for you. We are all in this together, the game of life, especially the teams behind me. Go Tigers! And go Mudhens! Victory is sweetest when you have tasted defeat. Have a nice night, everybody. I will see you tomorrow for another edition of All Andy Offered. Love you, Sarah.